Hello, hello! So today let's make a Wilder style star lantern like this one. For this, what you basically need is just a square piece of paper and some scissors, and that's it. A bone folder or a cutlery knife can help when you fold the folds, and if you want to paint your paper first, you can use a paintbrush, kids grade watercolors, a rug and a bucket of water. And that's it. Now if you want to color your paper, you can, if you want soft transitions, you can just wet it out first with plain water. It's a very easy technique. It's called wet on wet and it's perfect for watercolors. You've probably seen it on some more professional grade watercolors, but even with kids grade materials this still works. As you can see, these watercolors are far from being anything fancy. They're my kids' old watercolors that they don't need in school anymore, and I find it too bad not to use them. They're still perfectly fine for projects like this that don't demand high pigmentation and are just fine. A quick tip, if you ever want to make something look nice, just use the colors of the rainbow. That never looks bad. And you don't have to worry about your colors getting muddy, because the colors that are next to each other can mix. And you don't have to rinse your paintbrush in between too much. Just when you want to move from the warm to the cool, maybe a little bit. I will rinse now because I will go to the green, and I don't want my red and green to mix because that will make mud. This, when you work with kids grade watercolors, you find some colors are really chalky. And what I do, I just use less of them. It's really nothing special, but it helps. I know I could put some fancy watercolors here, but I want to show you that you can actually make, and I actually use this kind of stuff in my own practice because it's so freeing. You know, this paper was destined for landfill, and these colors would probably go in landfill if they were anywhere else, but I like to use them. So I cannot make these things much worse than they are right now. And this is not a painting that will hang in Louvre or be any that would need to look so nice. It just play, and the whole point of this is to have fun. So not everything has to be perfect, and especially not art. It probably won't be. Because these are so low pigmented colors, I go over it again to put some more on. And if you had watercolor and quote unquote real watercolors, you could maybe get away with one layer. If you want to put some purple in between, just use a little bit of red. While the paper is wet, you can play around all you want. And for the lantern, pastel colors are actually really nice. So don't worry. If you want, you can also put some dots with clear water, and this will make a special effect. I can show you what it makes. But we might have to wait a little bit for this effect to get noticed. If you like this tutorial or just feel generous today, give this video a like and subscribe to my channel, because I'll be making more in the new year. Now let's dry this off. Now my paper has dried and it's kind of wrinkly, but don't worry about that. Let's fold this baby up. First, we fold in half. You can crease with knife. And now diagonally. For the other diagonal, let's turn the paper and crease it like this. Now let's unfold it. And fold it together. Because we creased one diagonal in on the right side and the other one on the wrong side, it will just fold itself into this shape. Now we take 1/4, put a finger inside, and then fold it. If this is hard for you, we'll do this for all four. But if this is hard for you, you can first fold this in half. And then open and fold. Do whichever works for you. Now that we've got all of them folded, we'll cut this part off. And we're left with a layered triangle. We'll fold these parts up. And we don't need to keep them folded, we just need to have this fold. What I like to do is fold them in both directions. I fold it, unflap it, turn it, fold it in the other direction, and unflap it. Because we just need the crease. It's easier to fold if you have the same amount of paper on both sides. Although origami is very intricate work and you have to be really careful, this pattern is pretty forgiving. And now I've come to the first, because this one is already folded. Now we'll just open it all up. And now I will fold these flaps. I will fold this rhomboid, deltoid, to the inside, like this. And the last one. Now I've got a stack of this kite shape, and I will fold this upper smaller part of kite down. In mathematics, this is deltoid. I just turn it, get the next deltoid and fold it down. Turn, fold, and so on. When this gets bulky, just move them. Turn, fold. You're almost done. As you can see, this is already taking shape. We just need to make this pointy part a real bottom that a tea light could stand on. So we go inside and just push down. I'll show you from the other side. And I'm pushing. You can also push like from the air, like I'm doing now, or you could use your table as the other surface to push against. The circumference of this bottom circle, is up to you. You can make it taller or shorter. But always check that your tea light is fitting in. That's all there is to it. Happy celebration, whatever you celebrate. As you can see, all the small mistakes don't show up anymore, and it's in even kids' great watercolors can make some pretty nice results. I guarantee you anyone whom you would give this to will just like the gesture and not care about the fancy. Bye-bye and Happy New Year's!